taking your performance metrics and correlating them in a date time series is a great way to see where performance problems exist. It can exist in the database or on a server, or in your virtualization infrastructure, or pretty much anywhere in an application stack. So I'm going to show you how to use performance analysis to basically build the best kind of database dashboard you need. So to build a performance analysis dashboard, we'll just go to My Dashboards, Home, and Performance Analysis. We'll start with the database. So we'll add an entity. We'll select the database instance and select one of our databases. Today, people have been talking about the one in the NOC. So we'll select NOC SQL. We'll go ahead and add that. And so far, nothing's appearing, and that's as intended. To build out this dashboard, we'll expand database instance, select the instance underneath, and then pull some metrics. For me, I like wait time metrics. So I'm going to pull in the SQL one and maybe the status. So now I've got two different ones. You can see on this database instance, we are seeing some high wait times in a couple of places. Here, 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 notably. So let's see if we can connect that with something underlying in the system. To do that, we can go back to our instance, select this option here, and we'll add all other entities related to this. What this icon does is when you click on it, it goes back to the Orion system and says, what other elements that I'm monitoring that are actually connected to this, and then brings them into this view so you can quickly add additional resources. So starting with the basics, let's go ahead and see if we have some CPU problems here. So let's pull in percent memory, and then we'll go ahead and pull in CPU load, and we can put that directly on top of it because it's the same type, both percentages. We can see here that the CPU is not under pressure, but the memory is being consumed pretty high. That's not unusual in a database server. So maybe there is a different problem. Let's go ahead and bring in the volumes. Let's see how the disks are performing. Select the disk, select performance, see if we have some outstanding queue length. Certainly not. Let's try one of the other drives. Maybe we're having a problem on that one. Queue length. Again, since these are the same type of representation, you can just stack them. Queue length. Okay, there. So now we see a spike. So this looks like it might be a disk-related thing. But is it a disk exclusive to this server, or is it possibly part of the underlying LUN? We can actually pull that information in as well. We'll just go ahead and grab this LUN only, and we'll put it in a separate one. And if you drag over an element from the entities, we'll bring in the most common elements from that, and then you can weed them off if you like. So this doesn't appear to be at the LUN level. It seems to be something local. Let's backtrack and actually look deep dive into one of these spikes. So we can grab this area. And if you look over here, we have 123 seconds of wait time at about 5% of the total. And we can actually expand this and see the exact SQL that's being executed. That might be our problem. So it appears from this that the problem here for the wait time is actually in the SQL query itself and not in the underlying system. This is something that the database engineers and the database administrators really want to know. And to make that easy for them, we can just go ahead and save this. Give it a name, click Save. Now that it's saved, we can go to Settings, Manage Dashboards, and put it on one of our modern dashboards. So I can select this dashboard, hit Edit, add a new widget for time series data, and then find the PerfStack that we were using before. Then we can just drag and drop it anywhere on the page. So a couple of clicks to build a PerfStack project, and then a couple of more clicks to put it onto a dashboard, and now it's available for your database engineers, your database administrators, your server admins, your storage admins, and anyone else who needs to know about how the system is working right now.